getting ready for baseball under the roof in Houston. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the San Diego Padres and the Houston Astros. It's going to be a premier pitching matchup. Two of the league's hardest throwers go head-to-head next. Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr. He will lead this one off today. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. And the first pitch of the afternoon misses for ball one. And that's how we get things underway here in the Space City. And now this misses as well as he's behind the leadoff man this afternoon. 2-0 now.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker changeup combination. He's going to try and establish down in the zone to get swing and a miss or ground balls consistently. You have to find something above the belt to get loose on.
And now a slider is swung on and missed, and the leadoff man is set down to open up the ball game. Digging in now for San Diego, Manny Machado, a silver slugger winner a year ago in the National League. Swing and a miss, 0-1. A ball and a strike now to Machado. The 1-1 home.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
To the left side, but it's well foul. Bases are empty, one man out. Outside and low that time. Now it's two balls and two strikes. Still 2-2. Now Manny turns on one and sends it to deep left. Brantley going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And at the plate is Jake Cronenworth. First pitch of the AB now. Taken off the outside as the breaking ball couldn't catch the corner. Too much bite on the sinker, and he's behind 2-0 now. Now here's the pitch. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. McCormick finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Here comes the second baseman, Jose Altuve, to get things kicked off in the home half of inning number one.
The second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Now here's the first offering. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. A ball and a strike to Houston's leadoff batter. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
1-2.
What pitch recognition right there. 90% of the guys are going fishing after that nasty slider.
Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
Most good pitchers know that they have to work inside and sometimes even come off the plate to keep hitters from getting comfortable up there. I think that was part of the intent with that last pitch.
And this is going to get on through into center, a leadoff hit.
Batting second. No left fielder.
Darvish a check on first. Runners back. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. 1-0. As the first pitch here is a bit high, it's ball one. There goes Altuve. That evens it up 1-1. A runner at first with no outs here. There's the fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike. And And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 2-2. Now here's the ball hit high and deep to straightaway right field. And he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out. Striding in for Houston, Alex Bregman.
Third baseman, Alex Bregman.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
Ball out.
The 1-0 home.
That's the ball.
Well, this is a spot you'd like to be in. 2-0, good 2-0. Hitter. He's going to turn it loose right here.
Now a throw over to first.
He's in there.
Ryan Weathers is forced onto the mound now following the injury.
Number 40, Ryan.
Runner at first here, one man out. Line drive, base hit. Now a long throw to third. And he'll reach second now with one away.
Batting fourth. The designated hitter.
That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez.
Nope. Oh.
Lefty versus lefty, and the first pitch misses for ball one. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. 1-1 is looked at off the plate for a ball. Off-speed pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch on. This is indeed a battle. The 11th pitch coming up. And he looks at one that misses ball four, so that'll load him up, but at least the double play is in order here with one away. So now here is Carlos Correa looking to put them ahead early with this at-bat. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
So important getting ahead with the bases loaded. Already a difficult situation, so you don't want to make it any harder by falling behind in the count.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. Reined in. A jumping catch at second for one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Will Myers. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. So one down, no one aboard. And up next, it'll be the outfielder, Tommy Pham. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Two balls and no strikes to the Padres DH.
Two and out.
And this will ricochet off of him on the mound. Nice recovery play to get the second out, but we'll have to make sure he's okay on the mound. So next to hit is Eric Hosmer. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Grounded down the third baseline. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Now at the plate is Kyle Tucker.
Here you go. For the Astros, the right fielder, Kyle.
First delivery to him.
Tucker. One ball, no strike.
Now the 1-0. Swung on and chopped up the middle. He's right there. Throw to first is in time for the first down. So one out and nobody aboard. And digging in to bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Now a flare out to left center. Coming in is Myers, but he won't get there. It falls in.
Batting it, the seventh fielder.
Stepping in now, Chaz McCormick. This is a look at a changeup that drops below the knees for ball one. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Astro center fielder ahead with a 2-0 count. Has a look, now the pitch.
No, that missed.
He's really going to need to keep the walks down in this start. He's in danger of walking the second guy in two innings here.
And he'll just float a change in here now for a strike.
Three balls, one strike.
And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
The catcher.
A couple of runners on base with one down. And up next, the former Angel Martin Maldonado. He swings and grounds it to short. He's got it to Frazier at the bag. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Striding in is Victor Caratini. As we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Hot shot down the line. But a foul ball, 1-1.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
All even now, 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
The center fielder of the field, Trent Grisham.
Here's the first pitch. Strike one to start the at-bat. Started to go around there. Looked like he held up in time. No. Strike two, says the third base umpire. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
He went with the off-speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to get in, but you can't be too cute either.
So he sets him down swinging. Trent Grisham goes down for the first out here in inning number three. the belt. Kicks and deals. Adam Frazier stands in as he checks his swing here for strike one. Soft liner to the left side. There's one, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. Next to the plate for the Padres, Fernando Tatis Jr., recipient of a National League Silver Slugger Award for his contributions at shortstop last year. First pitch on its way.
One ball, no strike.
The 1-0 is offered at and missed for the first strike. Swing and a miss on the cut fastball. 1-2. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Bottom of the third now. Striding in the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve. First pitch on its way.
That's the ball. Outside.
The 1-0. And he fouls this one off. Now the 1-1 pitch. It is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Ready with another 2-2. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center. Grisham is under it to make the catch for out number one. One out now in the Houston third. And Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Here's the first pitch. A one count. Here's the pitch.
1-1.
Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Now a ball rolls softly to second. Scooped up. And there's out number two. Next up for the Stros, Alex Bregman. He singled in his first AB. Here's the pitch. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
Hey, always a good idea to take a couple of pitches when you're facing a young arm like this one. And now he's put himself in a real good hitter's count.
3-0 to him now. Into the windup and the pitch. A swing and a ground ball to third. That gets through and he'll reach base again on his second base hit of the game.
Number 34. Designated hitter.
To the plate now, Yordan Alvarez. As he'll take a first pitch curveball right down the middle for strike one. In there, and he's ahead 0-2 now.
Boy, this is one of those ABs you like to hit the rewind button on. Put himself in a tough spot now, hitting with two strikes.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. The 1-2 pitch.
2-2.
Well, that's back-to-back off-speed pitches, and he wasn't biting on either. Now let's see if he goes back to the hard stuff or gives the softer stuff another shot.
Runner on first with two away. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Hit hard on the ground to the right. And that's through for a hit. And they won't even attempt to run on that arm in right. So despite the runner moving on the pitch, it'll wind up first and second here. So next to swing the bat will be Carlos Correa. As he lifts it in the air to right field. And Tatis is there to end the inning. Set for the start of the fourth, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Manny Machado.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
And a strike to even the count, 1-1. Lays off the slider that time, 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
He's falling behind now, 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Oh, and he was fooled that time on the pitch away as he went around for strike two. On the ground up the middle. And the Friars are into the hit column.
Now batting.
Standing in now, Jake Cronenworth. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Slider, and that's in there for strike two.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning.
The left fielder, number five.
Here's Will Myers. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Struck out in his first at bat. Nothing in one count. Here it comes.
1-1.
Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Working for the punch out and the offering.
Nope, ball.
High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Full count, 3-2. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. And he misses with it. Ball four. So that'll load the bases. And now he's really going to need to get a ground ball. So here's the Padres DH, Tommy Pham. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one.
When you're hitting in a situation like this, you have to find a way to slow your heart rate down. The pitcher's the one with all the pressure. You're looking to keyhole something middle of the plate and drive some runs in.
2-0 count, the pitch. Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Looking up is Brantley. Gone! It's a grand slam! Eric Hosmer to the plate now. As the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one.
Boy, it's hard to let a grand slam go, but the only silver lining is now that you're working with a clean slate. Nobody on, nobody out. Got to treat it like it's a fresh inning.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Weak grounder back to the mound. And finally, there's the first out of the inning. Next to bat will be Victor Caratini. He drew a base on balls his first time up. Here's the pitch. Batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one.
I guess the game plan from the offensive standpoint today coming into this one was they were going to work the counts. They've been super patient at the plate in the early goings of this game, and they've got the lead looking for more.
And they'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. A bouncer to the left side. Bregman has it. Throw on to first to get him. Score 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. So two are gone in the Padre fourth, and that brings up Trent Grisham. And that's high ball. For a ball, 1-0.
1-0.
Four runs here in this half inning.
Yeehaw.
In there, 1-1. Hit the target,
the
but this is low, 2-1.
Well, I think he just kind of lost focus on the mound right there. It's clearly not going his way, and he's thinking more about that than the task at hand. And right
three
now, he
one.
Needs to think about this hitter.
And he looks at ball four now, so he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base. So here's Adam Frazier, 0-1 for him here in this one. And now the first pitch. Lays off 1-0, using the slide step to try to control the running game.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
Hey, I don't mind that batter taking that strike right there. He's walked a couple people early in this game. Got to find out if he can find the zone. If he wants to walk them all in, we'll take it.
Still 1-2. Has a look, now the pitch. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Digging in is the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. First pitch on the way. In there, strike one.
That's a tough curveball right there to stay into as a lefty hitter. That ball looks like it's almost going to hit you, and it breaks over the inside half of the plate.
1-1 the count now. Halfway to 100 pitches, here it is. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
And the throw on to first will take care of him, so he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away. So bases are empty with one out now. And digging in to bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. Hit hard on the ground to second. Reined in. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. Stepping in once again is Chaz McCormick. Worked a walk his first time up. And the pitch. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one.
Yeehaw!
Here's a breaking ball that falls in there for a strike to even things at 1-1.
Hey, be on the lookout right here. Usually when a pitcher drops in a curveball for a strike looking, now he'll try and throw it in the dirt, get you to fish a little bit. I want to see where he goes here.
Changes up on him, and that's in the dirt for a ball. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0.
Well, he's still out there to start the fifth inning, but it's been a real grind of a start for him. The pitch count is much higher than he'd like it to be, so it's hard to imagine him working really deep into this game.
Gould jumped the gun a bit on that swing, and he's down 1-2. Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. And now Manny Machado. He reached on a single last time and later wound up scoring. Here's the first pitch.
Although he doesn't use that pitch too much, if he's able to steal some strikes early in the count, could be something they have to think about.
1-1.
Down and away, ball one. Swung on and missed. 1-2
now. 1-2, the count.
Into the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss. Looked like the knuckle curve there, and that's out number two. And stepping in, Jake Cronenworth. 1-2 with a double on his line thus far. And a ball, 1-0. He takes it to the opposite field, high and deep to left. Not quite out of here. It's off the out-of-town scoreboard. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double. Zach Greinke, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Your attention, please. Now, pitching for the Astros, number 21.
Zach.
So here's Will Myers.
Right here.
As he will look at a first-pitch fastball for ball one. Runner in scoring position with two gone. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. Now the 1-1 pitch is in there for the second strike.
Take a step back right here. After three fastballs in a row, there is no chance he throws you a fourth.
Now Myers, a drive. This is to deep left field. Brantley has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. Now it'll be the catcher, Martin Maldonado. Now the pitch.
Maldonado.
The 0-1 delivery. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
This batter's got to be in his head right here. This is where you need to regroup. Fastball in, now change up down and away. This is the cat and mouse that I love about the game.
Under it is Machado, and he'll take it for the first out. Now one down with the bases empty, and that'll bring in Jose Altuve. Here's the first pitch to him. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Hosmer onto the grass, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. Here's Michael Brantley. He'll take a look at a pitch too low. It's ball one. 0-2 from him so far in this one. 2-0 to Brantley.
Two balls, no strike.
Clearly working the bottom of the zone, trying to get a ground ball for a double play.
Hold hard, but it's foul down the first base side. The 2-1. Swing and a liner. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. From the stretch. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. Cronenworth backs up and takes care of it. Two away. And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Alex Bregman. Two base hits, both singles to this point. He's set. Here it comes. He'll swing and lift a ball fouled off to the left and out of play. 0-1, here's the pitch.
There seem to be different philosophies on it. So, Dan, what was your approach in 0-2 counts?
My philosophy is this. I think the last thing you want to do is throw non-competitive pitches, Matt. Throw something down in the zone or just out of the zone. But something way out of the zone doesn't serve any purpose.
That's the ball.
Breaking ball misses the corner. Two balls and two strikes. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And Hosmer will just look this one in, and the inning is over. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And up next, it'll be the outfielder, Tommy Pham.
Hey, the difference in this one, they lead by four. Go back to this guy's previous AB, a towering grand slam that knocked in four runs.
0-1 the count. Greinke gets the sign. Here's the pitch. Fastball over the outside, but in there for a strike.
Two balls, two strikes.
Pretty unusual that you see a 5-0 hitter take two strikes in a row. Typically, are some of the most aggressive batters in the lineup.
One ball and two strikes to count. And that's high
ball,
for
high.
A ball. It's 2-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Next to dig in, Eric Hosmer, 0-2 for him to this point. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. There's
that's
a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
1-0.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Now the 2-0. A swing and a miss, strike one.
Two balls, one strike.
Four runs, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Hosmer in front now at 3-1 count. And that's outside. He lost him ball four. Next up is Victor Caratini. He grounded out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
McCormick calls everybody off as he takes control for out number two. So stepping in is Trent Grisham. It was a walk in his last trip. Now here's the first offering. Swing and a little tapper. Two out with the man at first. In there, and it's 0-2 now. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2. From the belt, the pitch. Skied down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Ball two.
No, that missed. Two balls, two strikes.
Fouled off. Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed, strike three. Matt Strom enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for San Diego, number 55.
Bottom of the inning now, and standing in is the DH, Yordan Alvarez.
Leading up for the Astros.
Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch.
Alvarez.
The 0-1. Here's a swing, and he loses the bat from his hands as it heads over toward the first base dugout. Looks like everyone's okay, however. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. Next to hit, Carlos Correa. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. From the stretch, here's the pitch.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Swing and a miss for strike one. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here comes the 1-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Now to bat, Kyle Tucker. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. First pitch on its way. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. That's taken for a ball, and it's 1-1 now to the Astros right fielder. And the pitch.
What we're seeing here is a guy getting pitched to very carefully. It doesn't matter that there's two outs and nobody on. He's a threat to score even when he's standing in the batter's box.
And, he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now. struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. And now in the box, Adam Frazier. He'll lead it off against Zach Greinke to open up the inning.
Adam.
Here's the first pitch now from Greinke. Wind up and the 0-1. Flipped out the other way towards short, and one gone. And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. First pitch of the AB now.
Ball.
One out, nobody on. Donnie couldn't pull that one back
ball,
as
one
he
strike.
Clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. Fouled away. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him. At the plate now is Manny Machado. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. First delivery to him. Now a swing and a miss.
Took
something off that one, and it's strike one.
Man, this pitcher is on right now, pounding the zone, attacking these hitters. He's making it look easy.
One ball, one strike, the count. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two.
2-1's the count.
And that misses
off the
plate and low, so it's 3-1 now. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Fielded cleanly. And a close play at first, but he's called out and the side is retired. Last half of the seventh here, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Yuli Gurriel.
The first baseman, Gurriel.
Here's the pitch. Gurriel swings, and it's hit very well out to left. It's up onto the train tracks and out of here. Austin Adams comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number seven. Into the box now, Chaz McCormick. As he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. He went down on strikes last time up. Lays off the slider, and it's 1-1. McCormick is a very well-regarded defensive outfielder. Used to be the fielders were evaluated mostly by the eyeball test and simple stats like fielding percentage. But, of course, these days there are many more advanced ways that help determine a guy's work in the field. And in his case, he shines in many ways.
You know, Matty, for me, I think he does pass the eyeball test. I know you have to look at all the numbers and the analytics to really appreciate a ball player like this. But, man, does he come to work every day and play hard.
Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away. First offering.
Maldonado.
Good.
That's three straight sliders in a row. I'd be shocked. I would be shocked if he went to that well a fourth time. I'd be looking here.
1-1.
Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. 2-1.
This right-handed pitcher, his bread and butter is that two-seamer, and he loves to throw it inside.
He's falling behind
three
now,
3-1.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
Myers is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. So up to the plate next will be Jose Altuve.
Altuve.
And now pitch on the way. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
One ball, no strike.
Wouldn't mind the pitcher expanding the zone a little bit more and using his aggressiveness against
him.
One run, seven hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Too tight with that one. 3-0. Michael Brantley would be next if they can keep this inning alive. He loses him on ball four. Daniel Hudson takes over on the mound now as he'll try to get the final out of the ballgame here and pick up a save. Michael Brantley will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. As a look, now the pitch. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
And it's a called strike to even the count at one.
Everything this guy throws is hard. That changeup he throws is in the high 80s to go along with that good heater.
And he's keeping it down here, and that's a called strike two. Last strike now for Houston. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Right to him. Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Hey, it's not easy to win a game, but particularly when you only get four hits. But that's what good teams do when they play good baseball. It's not all about getting hits. It's about pitching, defense, and base running. They did those areas quite well in this one.
And the score finishes 4-1 today. San Diego earned the victory despite only collecting four total hits. Ryan Weathers takes home the win. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ballgame for the victorious San Diego Padres. Four runs on four hits. No errors. They left four men on base. For the Astros, one run, seven hits. No errors. They left nine runners on base. Time of the ballgame, 2 hours and 53 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely. Got a call, boy, if you got it. Going down.